Welcome back to our channel. Today we're looking at pre-commit, a tool that can help you manage and maintain your pre-commit hooks and save precious CI pipeline minutes. So what exactly is pre-commit, right? So pre-commit is a framework for managing and maintaining so-called pre-commit hooks. This is information that goes into your Git repository and can then react to whatever you want to commit into that Git repository, right? So it allows you to ensure that your code meets certain standards before it actually gets committed into your Git version control system. Meaning, if my code is bad, it won't even get into the repository, right? That's a great way to keep your code base clean and consistent. And it's also a fantastic way to save on CI/CD resources, right? As you can catch issues early on before your CI pipeline even starts to run. We do not want to waste these precious GitHub Actions and GitLab CI minutes, do we? Right. Here we are at the official pre-commit website. As you can see, it's packed with resources, documentation to get you started. Installing is quite easy. You just need to install pre-commit through the pip Python package manager, right? So if you have Python already installed, you probably already have pip. You can also install it through your package manager of choice usually. So I'm on a Mac here, I'm using Homebrew as my package manager and I can install it from there as well. Once you've installed it, it becomes available on your command line. So here in this directory, we can run the pre-commit command and check, for example, the version that we have. Next, let's set up a configuration in a project to make pre-commit actually work. I'm using the Z text editor here. If you're curious about Z, you know, we have a great video on that that you can enjoy as well. However, pre-commit works with any text editor, right? It doesn't care about how you edit code files at all. This is a directory containing a couple of files. I hope you're able to see that. Just zoom in very quickly. All right. So you can see that it's containing a Go file, which is not optimally written, right? I have some variables that are unused and other things, you know, that are not up to the quality of Go coding standards. We have a markdown file here with some README information. I have a YAML file containing wrongly formatted YAML code. As you can see here, this should be aligned here to the left. This is all on purpose, of course. There's also a shell script here, which is also not optimally written, right? And if this would hit our CI pipeline and we have some linting tools set up there, then these would probably complain about the formatting of our files. And to avoid that, we're gonna use pre-commit. To set up pre-commit in any directory, we need to add a new file that's called pre-commit-config-yaml file. So .pre-commit-config.yaml. And in there, I can add these pre-commit hooks. I've prepared one here off screen to speed this up. Here we have a very simple pre-commit hooks that you will find in almost every open source project out there, also in all our Infralovers repositories, right? Very simple pre-commit hook that checks that all files don't have a trailing white space, you know, the end of line fixer is done, that all the YAML code is correctly formatted, and that we're not checking in any super large files that Git doesn't like, right? All the information what this pre-commit hook is doing is stored in another open source repository that belongs to that hook. So if we are checking this out in the browser here, you can see we have a collection of pre-commit hooks here, right, that we can use some documentation here and so on. So this is a third-party pre-commit hook, very convenient. First of all, this directory has to be a Git repository, right? So I'm gonna make a Git init here. So we have the Git repository ready. Also, pre-commit can only check files that are in your staging area, right? So let's just add all of them to the staging area. And then I also need to make sure whenever I create a new directory or I'm cloning an existing Git repository that I run pre-commit install in it to make it aware of those pre-commit hooks. They are then installed into the Git repository. Let's just run it. How can I do that? I can either run a specific command for that, or I'm just trying to do an actual Git commit. Let's do that, right? So if I do Git status, you can see I have all the files here prepared for the next commit. And I'm just gonna do a Git commit with a message here. Well, initial commit, right? It's a good commit message, I think, for the first one. And if I run this, you can see that there is additional command line output here. And this command line output shows me all the different hooks, all the different checks that I've included here that are being run. I have four here, right? And you can see these four areas here. Trailing white spaces is fine. End of files is fine. However, it's checking a YAML file. It's checking our config.yaml file. And it's failing here, right? Because this YAML is not perfectly formatted. The check, added large file check, then is passing again. And this commit has not happened, right? So there's still no commit in my Git history here. It's just blocking the commit from even happening until I have fixed the issue. So if I'm moving in to that config YAML file and I'm fixing the issue, which means aligning this here, adding all the changes again, if I'm trying to do a commit again, it's again running through. You can see all of these checks are passing and the commit has actually happened, right? How awesome is that? Okay, so with that, I've shown you a predefined commit hook, pretty standard YAML files and so on. However, I also want to show you how I can add a linting hook for my main.go file. So for that, I've also prepared a YAML block here that we can use for that to get the Go linter here going. This is not very well formatted, so let's just move that over. This is using Golang CI lint. For all of that, I'm saving that into my pre-commit hook, just running the pre-commit install. Here again, just to make sure everything is here that we need. And this time I'm doing this manually without doing the commit, so I can even check if my pre-commit hooks are happy or not by running a command like pre-commit run dash dash all dash files. If I run that, it's checking all my hooks again. You can see the first four are still happy, but the fifth one that we've just added is failing. You know, it's telling me in my Go file there's an unused variable, also some other things, you know, that we're not doing correctly. This is great, right? Because if this commit would have made it into the CI pipeline, any linter there would probably have picked it up. And, you know, this would have not only been very embarrassing for me in front of my colleagues, but also cost us precious CI pipeline minutes that we usually have to pay for, right? Unless, of course, we're running our own CI system. But if you're using GitHub Actions or GitLab CI, you know, everything, well, basically every minute counts. So adding these predefined hooks here is very easy. You can just basically look on GitHub, you know, pre-commit and then the programming language you're interested in that you want to check on and so on, and you will find a repo containing that. What also might be interesting to you is that pre-commit allows you to create your own custom hooks, which can be very handy if your project has very specific needs. We've created an example here, so I've added these couple of lines to my pre-commit config YAML file. As you can see, it's not pointing towards a Git repository this time, but it's saying local. I'm supplying it with the path to a shell script. This doesn't need to be a shell script. This could be a Ruby script, a Python script. I'm just using a shell script here with the logic for my pre-commit hook that should check all other shell scripts in my directory. So every file that ends in .sh will be checked for, again, linting things. So this is going to be using a command line tool. This is the code of my custom script .sh. And what this will be using is a linting tool, a command line tool called shell check, which is, you know, a linter for shell scripts. Don't forget to make this file executable, right, with this command plus x custom script, right? So now it's executable. the pre-commit hook should be able to run this. Also, make sure that all the files you want to check, including this script, is part of your staging area. And with that, I think everything is in here that we need. Awesome. So let's just run pre-commit manually again and see if this works. And yes, it does. As you can see, my git hook here is still failing. I never fixed that. And my new custom hook is now also failing, even telling me, you know, that my custom script, shell script, has some inconsistencies in there, and so on and so forth, right? So with that, and also, by the way, as the shell file here doesn't have any bigger changes, let me just add an additional command here. So there's a change in that shell script as well. I'm adding it here, running that again. As you can see, now it also picks up the problems in that file, right? So again, as a reminder, pre-commit can only see files in your staging area, right? So if I'm not adding this, it doesn't really make sense. And of course, as you know, it will still block me from doing any commit here, right? So before I'm not fixing all of that, I'm not allowed to add this code to my Git repository. And there you have it, a quick overview here of pre-commit, a tool for managing and maintaining your pre-commit hooks. This can save you a lot of time and hassle by catching issues before they even make it into your code base. For more information or advanced configuration examples, please check out the official pre-commit website on pre-commit.com. Thanks for watching. My name is Jürgen. If this video was helpful to you, make sure to check out our website, infralovers.com, and explore our courses and services. Feel free to leave any questions in the comments below, and I see you in the next video. Have a nice rest of the day.